Get Engaged, the Homeschool Connection. My name is Haley Kahn, and we have two guests tonight. Marc Saunders, the Director of Education and Training with Boston Partners in Education. And we also are lucky enough to have Moshay McLean, who is the Mentor Volunteer with Boston Partners in Education. Thank you both so much for being here.
Thank you for having us.
And before we talk about your individual roles, I'm wondering if you can share a little bit about Boston Partners in Education generally, your work in the city, your mission, what you do.
Sure. Well, Boston Partners in Education has been around for nearly 50 years, since 1966.
Wow.
So it's been a long time.
Wow, that
and
is.
We've worked in all that time with the Boston Public Schools in providing volunteers in classrooms to support students in their academic learning. And not only in their academic learning, but also in their social and emotional development as well. So we refer to them as academic mentors.
That's fabulous. So that's a wonderful summary, I think. Can you tell me a little bit about your role with the organization?
Sure. So my role as the Director for Education and Training is that I provide training to all of the mentors who go into classrooms. So I train in English language arts as well as mathematics in elementary as well as high school levels to prepare volunteers to go into classrooms to assist students. So that's my primary role. I also do work with connections with the Boston Public Schools and partnering with them and looking at other initiatives. One of the big initiatives that I'm doing right now is around family engagement. And so this makes a lot of sense. We have Moshay here, who is one of our, not only an academic mentor at one of our schools, but she's also a parent of a Boston Public Schools student.
Fantastic. Can you tell me a little bit about your work and sort of how you came to even know about Boston Partners in Education?
Well, one day I was going to class and I happened to see they had a display at my school. I go to UMass Boston and they had a volunteer opportunity. So I signed up. I emailed, got some email correspondence back, and it was, you know, the rest is history.
And you have a child who's in a Boston Public School,
yes.
Correct?
Yes, I do.
And does the organization work in that school?
They do not work in my child's school at this point. No, they do not.
Yeah. Maybe someday.
Yeah, we're in about, last year we were in about 70 schools.
Wow.
And we had about over 700 volunteers in those schools, and serving about 2,000 students.
That is a big chunk of our students. That's fantastic. And this question is going to take us a little bit of a step back, but because you've been around for so long and because it's such a historic organization, can you share how it came to exist and the origins of Boston Partners in Education?
Well, I'm probably not the best person with 50 years of history, but I think that there were a group of folks who were really kind of interested, and I think that lots of them were parents as well, and they were concerned around ways and things they could do to support schools and to support students in schools, and so they started organizing and came together, and I think at the time there were also other like programs around the country and in this particular area in Massachusetts as well. I think there's a similar organization in Cambridge. There were some other organizations as well. So they came together, became a nonprofit, independent nonprofit.
That's fabulous.
And then partnered with the Boston Public Schools.
And I'm sure the organization has evolved along with the Boston Public Schools over the last 50 years.
Yes, it has. It has.
Can you speak a little bit more about your vision and this story about engaging families more and empowering families more in your work or parents?
Sure, absolutely. We really feel that that everyone can really make a difference, and that the primary work that happens in schools is around instruction and learning. And that when families, especially when families get an opportunity to be in classrooms and engage in a classroom around that instruction and that learning, they get a real good sense about what's happening, how that works. They get a deep appreciation for teaching and learning and some of the challenges that teachers go through. That makes them better at their own work and supporting their own student. It makes them better in terms of citizen and supporting schools, which is our major institution in our community. And so that's really the drive. So how do we get more families in schools serving in classrooms around education and learning?
That's wonderful. And I'm wondering, you as parents, what do you think of this vision of engaging more families in the classroom? How has your experience as a parent changed by your work in the schools?
It's very rewarding, mm-hmm. and I love volunteering, first of all. But I feel like, you know, parents getting involved in the education, mm-hmm. that way they do know a little bit more about what their child's doing, how mm-hmm. their behaviors are in the classroom, mm-hmm. and how they interact with other students, as well as their engagement with the teacher mm-hmm. also.
And has your own understanding of the schools changed since you've started this work?
Not really. Okay. I can't say it hasn't.
Okay, well, that's, you're probably a very involved, engaged parent to begin with.
Now, I would add this too, is that sometimes parents don't always feel like they are qualified mm-hmm. To be in a classroom and assisting students academically. Mm-hmm. And I really want to get the message out and remind them that we are serving students K through 12 mm-hmm. In reading, writing, and mathematics. Mm-hmm. And so at some level, at some grade level, you can support any student, every
Absolutely.
Student. And so it's really important to get that message out there. And I think parents bring something to classrooms that's unique because they are parents and they
yes.
have that experience of having a child and raising a
yes.
child. And they bring that with them, that passion, they bring that understanding with mm-hmm. them. And it really, I think, it opens up the classroom to mm-hmm. a broader community. And I think that has a leveling effect on students as well.
Absolutely. And you know, I was a teacher before I came to this work, and I do know how much support is appreciated. You can't do it alone as a teacher at all, ever. And having families in the classrooms and families at home being supportive and engaged is just the best thing for a teacher to have. So thank you for your work. I'm wondering if you could talk a little bit about specific programs that you offer. I know there's a number I have written here, but I'd love to hear from you things you're really proud of, things you're excited about that you're working on right now.
Sure. So we have three main programs.
Mm-hmm.
So we have our school volunteer program,
mm-hmm.
which is our principal program,
mm-hmm.
which has the largest number of volunteers in it. And
mm-hmm.
really that's K through 12, reading,
mm-hmm.
writing, and mathematics. So anyone can volunteer. We get parents, we get students, college students, we even have a few high school students.
Wow.
We get retirees, we get people from all walks of life
mm-hmm.
Who serve and volunteer in that program. We have another program called Math Rules, and that's a more focused program on mathematics. And it's working with students in small groups,
okay.
3 to 4, sometimes 5. And it's in grades 3 through grade 6. I think we've expanded to grade 6
mm-hmm.
recently. And so they're working in a few schools, limited schools.
Mm-hmm.
It allows us to get more data from
mm-hmm.
the school around
Absolutely.
Students and some benchmarks about how they're doing when we start. And then we can sort of take a picture after
mm-hmm.
That year engagement, see what kind of progress those students have made. And then we have another program, which is more of a corporate program. It's called our Big Cheese Reads program. And the Big Cheese Reads is actually celebrating its 10th year anniversary this year. And this is a corporate partnership
mm-hmm.
program in which we do a lot of our fundraising through.
Mm-hmm.
And so we get companies around throughout the Boston area who volunteer, their employees volunteer, and they come into our schools and they read to students for about an hour.
That's great.
So that's great, and they make a donation and contribution for that. And we have, again, our gala, which is
mm-hmm.
coming up this May. For our 10th anniversary.
You should give some specific information about that, just in case anyone's interested in purchasing a ticket. Are they allowed to do that?
I was not prepared to do that.
Galas are fun for everyone.
Yes, yes. But we can post that information.
Absolutely.
If folks are interested, they should come to Boston Partners
mm-hmm.
And education.com.
Okay.
And,
it is .com, not .org.
.org. Yes, thank you. And look us up on the web, and they can find that information.
All right, so bostonpartnersineducation.org, and I'm sure there's a lot of more resources and information on that website, right?
Yeah, tons of information.
Okay, fabulous. And I'm assuming, too, that, you know, I noticed the math rules classes and some of these programs definitely sound like one would need to be prepared before being a volunteer in that capacity. You do the training for those people, is that correct?
I do.
You ensure
yes.
they know what they're doing and they're not.
Right.
You're not just sending them into the classroom to teach math.
I hope not. I do my best, but keep in mind that the training is 2.5 hours.
Mm-hmm.
So we ask people to select a grade level
mm-hmm.
in which they feel comfortable in and competent
mm-hmm.
in. because in 2.5 hours, if you were interested in teaching calculus, no one's going to be able to teach you calculus in 2.5 hours.
That'd be
right?
a stretch.
It'd be a stretch. So it's really that folks are self-selecting areas in which they feel comfortable in.
Okay.
And the training is looking at some principles around math principles around teaching and supporting students in mathematics, as well as reading and writing principles. And then a lot of it's also around how do you mentor.
Okay.
In that classroom, and giving folks a sense of what that classroom looks like, what they can expect, and then how do they navigate that when things come up.
And what programs do you work with directly?
I work with the seventh grade at the Frederick Middle, and I teach, well, I don't teach, sorry.
But you do, you really do teach.
Well, I volunteer, but I help bilinguals speaking students read with reading comprehension, writing, you know, those type of things.
That's fabulous. So you see the other, so you've heard like a sort of technical side from you, and you're experiencing it every day.
Yes.
That's wonderful. What's your favorite part of the work?
My favorite part of work is seeing the light bulb go off. When
That's
the
fantastic.
Child is struggling to read, but then they pronounce that word perfectly, and it's like, oh, wow, like I did it.
It's a fabulous feeling.
Yes.
And how much of a time commitment is a volunteer with Boston Partners in Education usually committing to?
So we ask for a minimum of 1 hour a week, and we ask them to serve for from whatever period they start throughout the school year.
Okay.
But some folks can give more time, and we're happy for more time if they have more time.
How much time are you in the school for?
I'm starting at 1 hour a week.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, that's fabulous. It is really important, I think, to be consistent in children's lives. You don't want people dropping in and out, and you know, there's a lot of that in children's lives, unfortunately. So you want consistent volunteers.
And it takes a while to build a relationship as well. So I mean, the consistency is about building a relationship, of being a constant in that child's life, getting to know them and understand who they are and how they learn, and so that you can get to figure out how best to serve them and help them. And over a long period of time, too, you get that reward of knowing that you're helping them, right?
Yes.
Because you've been there for few months.
Relationships, I've always believed this, relationships are the foundation of education, and you can't, as a teacher, as a parent, as anyone, move forward unless you have connections and relationships. So I'm glad to hear.
I agree.
Yeah, I'm glad to hear about that. So if a person, a parent out there, wanted to become involved with your program, how would they begin to volunteer? How would they start that?
So we do our best to get out there and communicate and let folks know that we're here, and that's why we're doing the show. And we have these wonderful opportunities for them to serve in the Boston Public Schools. So they can find our information online, again, at bostonpartnersineducation.org. I don't want to keep saying .com. .org. And if they want to volunteer, they can go on there and fill out on the volunteer section, fill out an application. It'll take you about 8 to 10 minutes, maybe less. And then after you fill out that application, we will contact you either through email or phone, invite you in, do a very quick interview with you as part of our process. We interview all our volunteers. We do also do a background check. It's through the Boston Public Schools as required.
Good thing though.
And then we set you up for a training, and I'll be your trainer.
Okay, fabulous.
And then once that happens, we'll place you.
And this is for families or students, this is for a range of people?
It's for a range of people. Anyone who has an hour a week, and I say that's not a lot of time, that folks can sometimes find an hour of their week to volunteer, and it's doing a great service to the community.
Wonderful. And if you had a recruitment message for families or anyone out there to sort of try to get them to come volunteer, what would your recruitment message be?
My recruitment message would be to families, if you have a child that's in BPS, the best way to see how the child is doing as far as their educational goals and needs are would be to volunteer.
To volunteer in the schools.
It would definitely be to volunteer, yes.
Wonderful. That's great to hear. And I would also say that if you're not a family or not a parent, experiencing learning with a child is one of the best things you can do. It's a magical experience. So I recommend everyone give it a try.
Yeah. Rewarding, very rewarding.
It's a great strategy as well mm-hmm. for a parent. If you have a child who's in the fourth grade mm-hmm. And you serve in the fifth grade, you have a preview. Even if it's not your child's yes. school or your
Absolutely.
Child's class, you have a preview of what they're going to be experiencing. So
Absolutely.
It'll be much better equipped mm-hmm. to support them throughout that after your year of service in the fifth grade.
Absolutely. Do you get many people coming for multiple years of service?
We do. We have folks who have been around longer than I've been there.
Wow.
And that have been serving. And sometimes they build a relationship, a wonderful relationship with the teacher.
Mm-hmm.
And to the point where they're working with that teacher and helping supporting curriculum development
so
in that
great.
Classroom. The teacher really sees them as an asset.
That is fantastic. And I'm just curious about you, too. You mentioned that you're in school, right?
Yes.
Are you in school for education? Or are you in school?
I'm actually in school for criminal justice.
Oh. Yes. Do you see your work as connected to your future work, connected to your work now?
I do.
Tell me about it.
Well, see, children are our future, mm-hmm. and we need to invest a lot more into them in order
Absolutely.
For our future to look the way we want it to look.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel like, you know, no matter what type of work I do, mm-hmm. I still want to stay on board and continue to volunteer with Boston Partners in Education.
I have a colleague who always talks about being involved in education because he wants to make sure everything is okay when he retires. It really is the future, though. You're absolutely right. What has been your favorite part of the work you've done in the last few months?
My favorite part is meeting the students,
mm-hmm.
All students from various backgrounds mm-hmm. culturally, and also meeting the teachers as well. It's been it's been a good experience for me.
Has any of your understanding of the way school is, the way curriculum is, or even students are changed since you started working with Boston Partners in Education?
Has it changed?
Do you have any new perspective?
Like from
yeah.
my day? Oh, definitely.
I mean, do you have any new perspective, I guess, on education today or the school, way schools are? Any new insights you can share with us?
None really.
Okay.
None that I could think of.
Okay, like, that's great. That is just fine. Maybe you knew a lot of stuff going in.
Yes.
And I'm wondering, what's your favorite part about working with Boston Partners in Education, Ben?
Well, you know, my favorite part has to be all the different people that come in the door. We last year 700 people, so on a yearly basis hundreds of folks are coming in, and I get to touch almost all of them as a trainer, and they're coming from all over the planet, all different walks of life, so it's very engaging for me. Another part that I'm really enjoying too is taking a deeper dive into mm-hmm. the family engagement piece.
Absolutely.
And right now I'm conducting a project with Northeastern University
mm-hmm.
And their civil engagement program mm-hmm. project there at the university. I have six students
wow.
from Northeastern who are pairing with six Boston public schools
mm-hmm.
and that are taking a closer look at those schools, surveying and questioning and interviewing people to understand better on the ground what family engagement truly looks like
That's
for those schools.
A fabulous, fabulous message. We have just a couple more moments to wrap up, and I'm wondering if before we go, you could talk a little bit about any upcoming events, upcoming initiatives you're doing that either of you are excited about.
Well, the main thing I'm really excited, again, I'll keep plugging this, is that every parent, mm-hmm. every person out there, if you're interested in volunteering with us, please do so. Go to our mm-hmm. website, sign up, give us a call,
mm-hmm.
Send me an email. I'm mm-hmm. happy to speak with you directly if you have more questions. But again, you can sign up. It's a very quick process.
Mm-hmm.
We'll get you in. We'll get you trained. We'll get you sent out and matched to a school.
That's fabulous.
And we do have our big gala coming up, and you can find out more about that online. It's a little expensive, but...
Well, some people have the money, but it's a lot of fun if they do.
But you can come. It's a wonderful thing to come to.
And do you have anything you're looking forward to?
Going to the gala. I am looking forward to continuing volunteer work in Boston Partners.
All right. Thank you so much both for being here. My guests this evening have been Marc Saunders and Moshay McLean with Boston Partners in Education. And from all of us at Get Engaged, thank you very much and have a lovely evening.